The Philippines posted a trade deficit of $3.2 billion in March. That is the narrowest figure since May of 2021. Now, imports fell 20% to $9.3 billion from a year earlier. It's the biggest drop since July 2020, when imports fell 20.8%. Exports, on the other hand, fell 7.3% to $6.13 billion. Electronic products continue to be the country's top exports, with total earnings of $3.59 billion. That's over 58% of the country's total exports during that period. Philippine senators raising the alarm on possible spying activities by offshore gaming operators in the country. Senate Deputy Minority Leader Risa Hontiveros said they have received reports two POGOs that were raided in Bambantarlac have high-tech equipment and can be used for surveillance as well as hacking activities. Fellow Senator Sherwin Gatchalian agrees with this observation. He also fears syndicates in POGOs already know how to circumvent the country's justice system.
During the executive session, some members of the PAOC, the Presidential Anti-Crime Commission, as well as some intelligence personnel, informed us that because of this technology and because of the internet, this technology can actually be used for cyber attacks, for surveillance purposes, and other cyber activities. These criminal syndicates studied exactly how to go about our justice system, how to circumvent our justice system. They studied very well how to use money in order to get away with their criminal activities. And that's what I fear. Once they have penetrated the upper echelons of our enforcement agencies.
An official of the Information and Communications Technology Department also backing findings on the possible involvement of POGOs in espionage and cyber attacks.
There had been several POGOs which were raided, and whose and information was provided by DICT to law enforcement agencies about them using technology to bypass some of our legal regulations. So I think that the general consensus about fears on the operation of POGOs is not unfounded.
SM Investments and SM Prime announced the creation of a $3 billion European medium-term note program. The C Group says the move, previously reported in April, will allow it to tap the offshore bond market for funding of its growth and expansion. Speaking of SMIC, it reported today quarterly net profit of 18.4 billion pesos. Revenues also slightly higher, with its banking segment accounting for more than half of the net earnings. Property follows along with retail and portfolio investments. Next, to Ayala Land, whose net income jumped 39% on the back of strong property demand and consumer activity. Its revenues at 41 billion pesos. Still from the Ayala Group, higher renewable energy output pushes ASIN's net income higher by 34%. Its renewables capacity also hit 4,800 megawatts in the first quarter. Another one in the RE field, First Gen with lower net income on weaker power prices and higher operating expenses. The Lopez Group's RE provider likewise saw revenues down to 33 billion pesos. And finally, Century Pacific Food, both with better net income and revenues, driving its top-line growth where its OEM exports and consistent brand segment performance despite inflationary pressures.